to the max with it. Racks.
I count six shots.
To the max hitting them, super lit, super excited, super happy to be bringing to you all, my YouTube family, To the Max News, where we cover everything New Jersey. I'm talking about North Jersey, South Jersey, East Jersey, West Jersey, and everywhere in between. Know what I mean? I hope everybody having a safe and productive day. And remember, if ain't nobody tell you they love you today, I love you. We here. Before we get started, man, click that subscribe button, man. If you're from Brick City, let me know. Click that subscribe, man. Drop that like for your boy. Please drop that like. That's gonna help me help y'all. I'm bringing it to y'all. You feel me? First things first, man. We're gonna get into this news clip. Headline reads, child amongst three people dead in overnight shooting in North New Jersey. Like I said, we're gonna have the news first. We're gonna hear what they had to say. I'm gonna get my own personal connection on the situation. And you know, like I said, man, leave that comment, man. Let me know what y'all thinking. Let me know how y'all feel. Let's go.
Three people confirmed dead following a shooting last night in Newark. Police sources say the suspected gunman also died. CBS's John Diaz is live in Newark. And John, what do we know now?
Yeah, well, Mary, good afternoon to you. Well, the victim's IDs as well as a motive have yet to be released. But neighbors around here are telling me that they heard at least four gunshots go off last night. And now, while police, they are still investigating what appears to be a double homicide, what is clear is that neighbors around here, they are just in utter disbelief, saying, you know, crime is never a good thing. But when it does involve a small child, it really is just unimaginable.
I heard a big noise. I thought it was somebody that dropped something on the floor. I didn't think of anything, like somebody was shooting upstairs.
He didn't want to show his face on camera, but the landlord of the residential building on Johnson Avenue, where police tell us two people were fatally shot Wednesday night, shared with us this surveillance video of his backyard. You can see it's filled with police moments after the deadly incident.
There's two people shot inside.
The landlord tells us his tenants just moved in 3 weeks ago, a mother and her seven-year-old child.
I thought that was him running around, you know, playing. I thought it was just the kids playing upstairs.
Neighbors say it looked like they were having a small party, but a law enforcement source tells CBS2's Christine Sloan there was an incident in which at least two people were shot, including a child. That suspect left the area and was encountered by Newark police, and as a result, he was shot. The law enforcement source says the attorney general's office is investigating. A gun was found on the sidewalk nearby, and neighbors can't help but to think about the child.
Now, we saw a person who returned back to this home earlier this morning who was believed to be the mother. Now, police sources telling us that the child was possibly shot at close range, and there was a female inside this home trying to protect that child. She was able to escape through a window. Meanwhile, the police union saying some of what they're learning about this case, and they're still learning a lot about it, still trying to put it all together, but what they are learning so far is just horrific. They do say that responding officers, the quick actions that they took, prevented more people from getting injured or more people from dying. But of course, keep it here with us. We'll continue to keep you updated. But for now, we are live this afternoon from Newark, New Jersey. John Diaz, CBS 2 News.
Okay, we're going to get into this news, this corresponding news report from RLS. You know, I'm read the news report. Well, I'm going to just give a brief summary of the news report, and then I'm going to give y'all my personal connection on this whole situation. Police arrived to the residential apartment building located on Johnson Avenue around 8:45 p.m. on a call that people had been shot inside the location. Police proceeded to the second floor where they found two victims that appeared to be suffering from gunshot wounds. One of the victims was a seven-year-old boy. He was later identified as Zamir Lopez. The second victim, a male in his late 20s, he was later identified as 27-year-old Walik Shaw. A third victim also walked into Beth Israel Hospital, who was present during the incident, suffering from gunshot wounds. He was listed in stable condition. Upon further investigation, police encountered the suspect a short distance from the crime scene, a male in his late 20s, early 30s. He had appeared to be holding a black semi-automatic handgun. A struggle ensued, which led to a brief exchange of gunfire, which ultimately ended with no police shooting the suspect dead. Before I get started, giving my own personal connection, I want to say my prayers and my condolences go out to everyone that was affected by this. If you were affected by this, let me know. Drop a comment down below. So here we go. So the suspect,
and also one of the victims, you know, well, I would say the victim, Waleed Shaw, rest in peace, man. That was my brother. He was a good dude, real good brother, solid brother. You know, he had values, he had morals, you know. Family was everything to him. He was also extremely talented. He could sing, he could dance, he can do it all, man. He had the whole neighborhood jamming to his music, man. So that's why it just hurts that much more, because given the right direction, right, you know, people behind him, I honestly could have seen this man living out his wildest dreams. So, rest in peace, Waleed Shaw. The suspect, I can't even say nothing bad, because he was a cool brother, you know. He was cool, you know, he's very cool, you know, he's very respectful, you know, he always showed me love, you know. So that's why I was just heartbreaking to hear. And also with another dynamic that, you know, the suspect and the victim, Waleed Shaw, they were like brothers also. You know, I have seen their relationship. I have seen how they go to bat for one another, like they were there for one another. So, you know, that adds another, an even more disturbing element to the whole situation, you know. But rest in peace to Zamir Lopez, man. My prayers and my condolences go out to your family. You know, I'm going to keep you guys in my prayers forever. There you have it. Like I said before, I'm sending my prayers, I'm sending my condolences out to everyone that was affected by this, man. You were affected by this, please, man, let me know. Drop a comment, man. Go comment down below. Let me know how you were affected by this. Also, if you enjoyed my video, man, hit the like button. I will be dropping new content daily. I'm talking about new news daily, you know. So, you from Brick City, you from 973, you from Newark, New Jersey, man, please let it be known. Hit that subscribe button, you know. So, until next time, stay safe, stay productive. We out.
Your friend, more like a bestie, more like a bestie.